Welcome class 10th students. Today we are going to start a new chapter for you, and this is called magnetic effect of electric current. Magnetic effect of electric current. This is new chapter. I think this in your NCERT it is given chapter number 13. Okay, so for introduction we will take directly a question, and this is called Oersted experiment. Oersted experiment, Oersted, Oersted experiment. He confirm the experiment about magnetism and electric current, the relation between magnetic and what electric, that is our electromagnet. Okay, so first see the what are the experiment. He took a wire, copper wire, aluminium wire, then he applied the potential, electric field, potential V, current is start flowing, current is start flowing. Okay, now instead of below, you can put it up a wire. You applied the battery or the Oersted and key. So many points are there. This is the Oersted. You better know this is electric circuit. Positive, negative, and key. Key is on. Current is start flowing. This is the current. Okay. Now what he do? He did. He put the magnetic needle. This is the magnetic needle. You better know this is compass needle, which tells the direction in GPRS as well. Magnetic needle. That was north and that this was south. He put the magnetic needle below the wire. When he switched on the circuit, he noticed that there is the deflection in magnetic needle. North become here NS and it become what? SS. Once again, he take a wire, applied the electric field. When switched on, the Oersted is there, control the electric current. When switched on, current starts flowing, and he put the magnetic needle, which magnetic needle just below the wire, just below the wire. Then he noticed that needle gets deflected. Initially it was horizontal, established in north south. You better know all time magnetic needle in north south direction, which tells the direction as well. Okay, when he switched on the circuit, it become N dash and S dash. It means there is the deflection in magnetic needle. Then he conclude that when current start flowing through any wire, then surrounding the wire magnetic field created. That's why this needle gets deflected. Deflection in magnetic needle confirm that there is the possibility or there is a creation of magnetic field surrounding it, although there was no source of magnet. So then we confirm that this current is responsible for this magnetic field. Are you getting the point? Magnetic deflection in magnetic needle confirm that it should be in the presence of magnet, although there was no magnet, but there was a current through the wire. That phenomena confirmed that when current drawn through any wire, then magnetic field created surrounding it. This phenomena is called, or this effect is called, magnetic effect of current. It means current is responsible for magnet, and this is done by Oersted. That's why it is called Oersted experiment. Once again, Oersted took a wire, applied the electric source, re-hosted and key. When switched on, current start flowing. You better know as like Ohm's law. He put the magnetic needle just below the wire or above the wire, where you want you can put. It depends, and because the direction will depend on the place, okay, or position. When he put the magnetic needle just below the wire, he noticed the deflection in magnetic needle. It gets deflected. The deflection in magnetic needle confirmed that the creation of magnetic field, no doubt, because magnetic needle only deflected in the presence of magnet. Although there was no magnet, still it is deflecting. It means current is responsible for deflection. It means magnetic field created surrounding the wire due to current. That's why this effect is called magnetic effect of electric current. Since it is done by Oersted, that's why it is also known as Oersted experiment. Note down the point, and this is the diagram for you. Okay, so this is the introduction. Now, next point is cause. What is the cause of magnetism? Since we had used here metallic wire, and you better know every metallic wire have a number of electrons, free electrons. When we apply the electric potential, electron gets mobilized. Note the point. Moving electrons behave as a magnet. What is the main cause? Moving electron behave as a magnet. When we switch off, needle become NS. When we switched on, yeah, we put the switch on, then again deflection. When you put off, no doubt electrons remains are in rest. When switched on, electrons are running. This is called electric current. And due to this moving electron behave as a magnet. So what is the main cause of magnetic effect? When we applied the electric field through any conductor, electron gets mobilized and moving electron behave as a magnet. Note down the point. Moving electron behave as a magnet. This is the cause of magnetic effect of electric current. Okay? And this is done by Oersted. That's why it is called Oersted experiment. Now, some more experiment done by the scientist. Let's suppose that is the wire and the needle was here. When we put the below, what happened? It get deflected as like this and become NS. In same condition, if wire is same, direction of current is same, instead of below, if we put the magnetic needle above the wire as like this, north and south, it move as like this. What is going on? Here its direction is anti-clockwise, here its direction is what? Clockwise. In the place of this, if we put the direction of current reverse and magnetic needle below the wire, what happened? It get deflection as like this. It put as like this, current is changed and position is changed, needle go as like this. So what we are getting the answer? Many experiment is done in the behalf of that Oersted experiment. In the Oersted experiment, was fixed because only magnetic needle just kept below the wire. Here below the wire, you better know this is Oersted experiment. North deflected upward. Here, when the position, current, direction of current is not changed, but position is changed, it will not become down. It means here direction is anti-clockwise. Here direction is what? Clockwise. Are you getting? Once again, if the direction of current is changed, you can see here. Here direction from the A to B. Here direction is of current is B to A. Direction of current is reversed, but position is same. You see there. Here needle was below the wire. Again here needle is below the wire. Here north pole deflected anti-clockwise. Here north pole is deflecting what? Clockwise. So what we getting here? The direction of magnetic field depends on two points. Note the point. By these all experiment, the direction of magnetic field depends on two points. First is called direction of current. If direction of current change, the direction of magnetic field gets changes. First point. Second, the position of needle. You can see here. In that cases, we have changed the position of needle, magnetic field gets changes. In that cases, we had changed the direction of current. Position is same, but direction of current is different. Here right side, here direction is left side. You can see there, magnetic field here anti-clockwise. Here magnetic field is what? Clockwise. Okay, so this is our next topic. It means the direction of magnetic field depends on certain rules, or it depends on two factors. First is direction of electric current, and second factor is position of magnetic needle. Okay, so first rule for to find out the direction of magnetic field. Magnetic field created, no doubt. Oersted already told magnetic field created when current drawn through any wire. Okay, but what will be the direction of magnetic field? This is not clear by that rule. Okay, so there are certain rules. So first rule today I am telling you, this is called right hand thumb rule. Very important. Most of question you will solve by this one. Right hand thumb rule. See the right hand thumb rule. If we hold the current carrying wire, you see here, this, let us suppose this is current carrying wire, by right hand such that our thumb represents the direction of current. You hold the wire by right hand such that this thumb represents the direction of current, then you rotate it. It means your curl of finger is as like this. This is anti-clockwise. It means the direction of curl of finger will represents the magnetic field lines. Once again, if we hold the current carrying wire by right hand such that our thumb represents the direction of current, let's suppose the direction of current is upward, then you rotate the hand, you are rotating as like this. It means it is anti-clockwise. in if the direction of current reverse, you better know if direction of current is downward, now you rotate, it become clockwise. So what we are getting, when direction of current is upward, the magnetic field lines are anti-clockwise. When direction of magnetic field current is downward, you rotate, now it become clockwise. This is called right hand thumb rule. Once again, if we hold the current carrying wire by right hand such that our thumb represents the direction of current, then the curl of finger will represent the direction of magnetic field lines, on which magnetic field will be perpendicular. It could be inward or it could be outward, and it's vice versa. If this is current, curl of finger will be line of force. If this is current, if your current is as like loop, this will be the direction of magnetic field. Once again, if this is the current, curl of finger will represent the direction of magnetic field lines. If this is current, instead of taking this, if you zoom, the current is in the loop, this will be direction of magnetic field. Okay, na? It means answer could be reverse. So once again, let's suppose this is long straight wire. This is your thumb. I am talking about this one. This thumb represents the direction of current. Okay. This is the curl of finger, as like this. Okay, are you getting the point? So this finger is, you can see here, your finger is as like this here, as like this. It means this is called magnetic field lines. This is called right hand thumb rule. If we hold the current carrying wire by right hand such that our thumb represents the direction of current, then the curl of finger, you can see there, curl of finger as like this, you see there, curl of finger will represents the magnetic field lines. Okay, that's all for today.